Watch and wait, Lord, anticipate the moment you choose to appear. We worship, we praise until there's no debate, and we recognize you already.
Feel him.
Amen.
When I feel God, my feelings don't matter. Hello, somebody. Because I know when I'm about to get to my feelings, that tell me God is somewhere near. Amen. Don't do it. 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 It ain't about you.
Amen.
It's about the journey that he... See, y'all got to understand something. You are earth. You ain't nothing but earth. And this earth that you walk on, a path has already been made for your life. Only thing you got, the only choice you got is to either choose God or not choose God. And if I don't choose God, that means everything that goes on in my life, I'm going to be always fussing and complaining because I don't like the path God put me on. But when I choose God, I'm content in all things. I'm happy in all things. I don't care what's going on. I got one choice to make. You don't make choices every day. That's the devil making you think you got a choice. Well, I chose to eat macaroni and cheese today. You better shut up and understand you got one choice.
Amen.
You can choose to eat that macaroni and cheese, and God allowed the macaroni and cheese to choke you like a chicken bone.
Amen.
But macaroni and cheese can't choke nobody. If God said it'll choke you, it'll choke you.
Amen.
So what I'm trying to tell you, you got one choice. Either choose God or not. If I choose God, no matter what goes on in my life, I'm at peace.
Amen.
If I don't choose God, I think I have made a bad choice.
Amen.
In the route in which God said I was going to go.
Yeah.
And I'm going to be upset with my life.
Amen.
Or I can talk about this because I live there.
Amen.
I can talk about that because I ain't got one t-shirt, but about 100 of them.
Amen.
But I thought I was making choices, but it was really the route that God gave me for my life. And ugly as I am, ain't nothing I can do about it. So if you can't do nothing about the way you look, why do you think you can do something about the way you live?
Amen.
Hello, somebody.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
If you can't do nothing about the way you look, if God took control over your looks, why you don't think he's going to take control over your life?
Amen.
Stop it now.
Amen.
Choose him so you can be at peace.
Yes.
Choose him
yes.
so you can go forward.
Yes.
Choose him so you can start wrestling with life. Because you ain't when you fussing me, you ain't fussing at me. You're fussing at my daddy who made me. When I fuss at you, I ain't fussing at you. I'm fussing at the creator, not the creation. I'm mad because God put you in my life. Father, I thank you right now.
Yeah.
I thank you for giving me an understanding that surpasses all understanding. Because when I got to the place of getting the understanding that surpasses all understanding, now I can let everybody else know it's not only privilege for me. God has that place for you. He said, come out of the abyss and don't miss the surpass that belongs to you.
Amen.
Meaning I can have everything that God says I can have. I can be all things that God says I can be. I can do nothing but fail because my creator can do anything but fail. So why am I looking at myself as a failure when God said I was created in his image? And God, if God is not a failure, how can I be created in his image and fail? It cannot be. But I let the world tell me that I'm making some failure choices instead of living a life beyond my understanding.
Amen.
So Lord, the greatest understanding I have now, and I'm proud of this understanding, is that I don't understand. What do you understand, Bishop? I understand one thing. And I'm happy today because I'm at peace. I don't understand. Because what gets you out of whack is trying to understand what somebody did to you. What gets you out of whack is trying to understand what somebody said about you. What gets you out of whack is trying to understand why you did what you did. So just know what? I don't understand. And keep some peace in your life.
Amen.
Hello, somebody.
Hello, somebody.
If God be for you, who can be against you?
Amen.
The reason you're trying to understand is because you don't understand that God is for you. And I lean not on my understanding, but the understanding that got all things, the understanding that can give me all things, the understanding that can protect me through all things, the understanding that says I'm a winner and not a loser. Because we don't win or lose, we win or learn. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
I thank God this day for this word that is about to come forward. Everybody say amen?
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
And amen again.
Amen.
He's already here, saints. He's already here. This morning we talked about the power of a mother. That was part one of this sermon. We had an 8 o'clock sermon. You can go back and get it on Facebook. It broke up a little bit because I had without a memory on my media team. They've been rhyming lately. And so my media, when things go wrong, I had to get a substitute today. And Carol put some more memory on my iPad. So yesterday my Facebook kept going off. Didn't realize I was out of memory. Y'all got to show me how to delete some of that stuff. All right, can you help me out with that? Can you help me out? But now your mama told you about we're going to do Zoom. We got to get hooked up. Y'all find out about the Zoom. We got to get hooked up on the Zoom. Because when we do the Zoom, they can talk to us and we can talk to them. But God, I might just stay on Facebook because Brother Terry get on Zoom, we ain't going to be able to have no message. Yeah. You got some of them, man. They can talk back. You ain't going to get through it, you know? So we going to be coming in with Zoom then. We're going to be Zoom. So y'all get ready. Zoom. I ain't talking about the Zoom by the Commodore. I'm talking about Zoom. We're going to be on Zoom. It was nice. nice. I like the way it operates, and we can have our meetings and do things. But anyway, I thank God this morning, as we spoke this morning, we talked about the power of a woman. We talked about how she, part one of the sermon was the power of a mother. We talked about how the mother was the coach of the house. We talked about how the mother was the intermediator between the children and the intermediator between the parent, the dad, and the children. And then we talked about how the woman, because we're going to talk about this a little bit today, her love is so strong for kids because of the pain she endured. Just like God said, you shall be just like me. Because you caused me much pain, woman, you shall endure pain to bring life into this world for me. And so now you understand why God loves us so much and why mothers love like God. And so mothers, a real mother teaches the world how to love for real, hold somebody. See, a father is a provider. A father is the one with authority, hello somebody. So now what is missing is the mother needs to learn authority from the father, and the way a woman learns authority from the father is to submit to that authority, that one day she'll be able to give that authority, hello somebody. But a father, a father needs to learn God from a woman. Ooh, Jesus, this is so good. That's why we hear the power of a woman. A power of a woman. A woman teaches us how to love. But before a woman can truly love a man, and this is what most men get over, they get lost because they want the woman to be with God. But they don't want the woman to learn the power of God. For a woman to learn the power of God, there's a season where she's got to make God all, everything. And as she's making God everything, you're going to feel like you're on second base. Maybe you're going to stay there if you really want a woman with the power of God. So we talked about the power of God, a power of a mother. A mother teaches us how to love through pain. And this is what's so amazing. Some mothers they have a child. They're not like Vanessa. Vanessa calls her mama so much pain. Her mama said, no more. But some mothers they have a child and they know the pain that is to come. You understand what I'm saying, Missionary Bell? They know the pain that is to come. And they say, I love this man so much I will endure the pain that is to come. So now I love, when you have a baby for the first time, you don't love before the pain because you don't know the pain.
That's right.
Am I right?
That's right.
So when you choose to have another baby, you love before the pain because you know the pain, then you love during the pain, and now you'll kill somebody because of the pain if they miss what the pain costs you.
Amen.
Y'all with me? So that's what we talked about this morning. But today, this afternoon, we're gonna get deeper into God. We're gonna get into the spirit of a mother. Somebody say the spirit of a mother. And I want you to hear this. I want you to hear this as we get into our scripture reading. Is coming from John chapter 1, verses 1 through 15. And the word of God reads in the Living Translation. John chapter 1, verses 1 through 15. John chapter 1, verses 1 through 15. John chapter 1, verses 1 through 15. And the spirit of a mother. And I will be going over to Genesis chapter 3, verse 16. And I'm going to break this down. I talk about this a lot now. When you hear me preach, I always talk about in the beginning. And the word of God reads, in the beginning there was the word. And the word was with God. And the word was God. This is King James. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life. In him was life. In him was life. And the light witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but he was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which liveth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him. And the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God, even to let them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, not of the will of flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelleth among us. And we beheld his glory. And the glory as the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. John bare witness of him and cried, this was he of whom I spake. He cometh after me. He that cometh after me is preferred before me, for he was before me. So as we hear this, we're talking today about the spirit of a mother. So now in the beginning, we're gonna take this and we're gonna break this down, and I want you to hear it for what it's really saying. He said, in the beginning, there was love. The word is love. And the love was with God. And the love was God. You hear me say this almost every time I'm gonna wake up with Jesus. And then verse 14 says, and the love was made flesh. And the love was made flesh and dwelt among us. So this was Jesus before man knew him. This was Jesus when man knew him as Jesus. And this was God without Jesus. Jesus, before man knew who he was, Adam knew him as God. We knew him as Jesus. So now he says to mankind, I am now God and Jesus. We're talking about a spirit now. The name of our church is the what?
Spirit of Jesus.
The name of our church is the Spirit of Jesus. The Spirit of Jesus says, I have the Spirit of God if I walk in the mannerisms of Jesus. Because Jesus' Spirit was given to him by who? God. Now we're talking about the spirit of a mother this morning. And as we talk about the spirit of a mother, it said, in the beginning, there was love. In the perfect world, Mother Mary Lee, in a perfect world, a baby is made out of what? Two people making
love.
Now, in an imperfect world, and this is what gets crazy, you cannot make a baby without love.
Amen.
So a one night stand, a baby cannot be made if there was no love in it. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
So if you have a baby in a one-night stand, there was love in it. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
There are many people who are professing to be in love that can't make a baby.
Amen.
You gave yourself to him. And he gave himself to you. If but for a moment, y'all became what? Y'all became what?
One.
When y'all become one, y'all make one. Unless y'all just have super love and y'all make two or three at one time. Praise the Lord. I'm back. And I'm real.
Amen.
Now notice what he says here. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light. See, my thing is, y'all don't like the way I preach sometimes because I tell you the truth about where you at. I didn't like him. But he got you pregnant. Hello, somebody. See, you position yourself with God. You position yourself with God where what? Where he can't tell you no. And one thing God will never tell, when you have a love moment, meaning a love moment, he can't tell a love moment what? No. I tell my sons all the time. When they were younger, you know, they used to be having their girlfriends, they'd be all pretty and cute. And I tell them, I said, you better follow her home. He said, why, Dad? I said, when knock on the door, when her mama answered the door, 15 years, 20 years from now, that's who you're going to be married to.
Yeah.
If you don't like the way the mama look, you better keep stepping.
Yeah.
I told him that. I'm getting real.
Amen.
Be careful what you give your love to. You might not like it 20 years from now. But we're talking about the spirit of a mother. It says, he came to bear witness of the light. He was not the light. I am not your life giver.
Amen.
Your mother is not your life giver. But nobody will love you like your mother, because the life that she gave you, she know where it came from. It did not come from the man. It came from the love. And love is what? And God is what? So it came from God. So you gave up a moment where you truly, in the heat of passion, believed in God, and but for a moment. Can I be real with y'all?
Amen.
Huh?
Yeah.
Can I just really, really be real? We all mature enough.
Oh, yeah,
baby. We find God, we say, oh my God, this is so good, I don't know what to do. You found God but for a moment. Mm-hmm. In the heat of passion. In the heat of passion. And both of y'all meet that place at the same time. Love meets love, and now love creates love. Come on, somebody. Love meets love, and love creates something to what? Love. Y'all with me?
Amen.
Now watch this. It says, I want to get somewhere. It says, your mama ain't the giver of life. I am not the giver of your life. Bishop, what is my purpose? I didn't give you life, baby. What I told you? You got to do what? I said, you got to go find God for yourself. I'm going to teach you how to hear from God. I'm going to teach you how to talk to God. And God will tell you what you need to know about your purpose. I did not pretend to tell you what your purpose was, because I know I am not the light. I am not the giver of life. Your mama ain't the giver of life, but she's so close to it. Because you can see that's where you came from in the natural. And when we see where we came from in the natural, we begin to honor where we came from. But if you understand, that is not the place to honor with all honor. The place to all honor with all honor is the one that put you in your mother's womb. God said, even before you were conceived in your mother's womb, I knew you. I had something for you to do. Now watch this. It says, he was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew not him. We sit around here and even though we had service this morning, we had a lesson of the heart moment too, didn't we?
Amen.
After I got through with the word, we began to talk about the word, and it was real good. And what we come to find out is, I have no life without God. I love my wife, but if God had not given me life, she wouldn't even know me. My wife loves me, but if God had not given her life, she would not even know. It ain't got nothing to do with mama and daddy.
Amen.
They were the vehicles of our understanding, but God is the vehicle of purpose. I sent you here for a purpose. I sent you here because I am going to put in you, if but for a day, where one person will believe that I am because of you. One person will believe that God exists because of you. Watch what it says here. And he came into his own, and his own received him not. How many times I walked up in this church after teaching y'all how to hear from God, and y'all were mad at me? Look what we said this morning. Huh? You're concerned about what a person is doing rather than who God is. I'm concerned about what you're doing. You're watching cars, and you ain't got no license. But I'm missing who God is. He was washing cars with no license, but he was making money because of who?
God.
Hello. See, I'm looking at, well, you ain't even legal. But the day he's legal, he gave a testimony this morning. Y'all give him a hand, because he wait, don't give it yet. We got to give our new member a hand, because he on the way. He ain't got no choice now. Because he messed around and said, the Spirit of Jesus planted the seed. He should have never told me that the Spirit of Jesus planted the seed. He said, there was something Bishop said. He said, Bishop said, except you cross this line, you'll never be able to really do anything. He said, so one day he decided to cross the line. And he went and got his license. He got his EIN number. He said, he crossed the line. He said, now I'm legal. I can go to the school board and watch cars at the school. And he said, I ain't got to be riding down the road. He said, I went to county. I go to county facilities, watch cars at the county facility. All because of a word that Bishop planted in him, and God made grow.
Amen.
That word was planted at his other church. He got two churches, y'all. He's been bootlegging on this for a long time. He got two churches.
All right, then.
But I told you, don't give me no ammunition. That God, is a word that was planted over him and made it what?
Glory.
And this is what we're seeing. What I'm saying is, whether a person, whatever a person is, y'all say, Bishop, you're real smart in the Bible and you know a lot about God. But that don't mean I'm not still what? Growing.
Amen.
And now you got somebody who out there on the street, and I'm still growing, and just because they're on the street and they're not professing God, they don't know God, that don't mean that they're not what? Growing. If you got life in you, that means God is still in you, and he is yet what? Growing something in you. And what is he growing in me? Oh my God, you stay out of my class. I'm glad that he's here. Because God is love. And the only thing God wants to grow in you is himself. He wants to grow you out of this world. And the way he grows you out of this world is he teaches you how to love. But before he can teach you how to love, he has to show you a love that you don't understand. I don't understand how a woman know the pain she's going to go through. Screaming and slobbing and spitting and cussing. And they forget all about that. That pain is so great. And see, y'all got to understand something. That's the pain God felt when Eve and Adam chose Lucifer over God. He said, woman, because you didn't make the man choose, but because you led him to this choice, I'm going to bring life through you. And I'm going to teach you what real love is through pain. Because in spite of the pain you have given me, I'm still going to love you and I will not kill you. I'm going to still love you. So now the woman comes out. She learns the pain of God. She learns how to love on the other side. Y'all understand what's going on here? So the woman now, notice, go with me real quick. Go with me real quick to Genesis. Let's go to Genesis real quick. We're going to go to Genesis 3. Genesis 3. Let's go with me real quick to Genesis 3, New Living Translation. Come on. Go with me real quick to Genesis 3 and 16, New Living Translation. And notice what God said to Eve. He said, unto the woman, he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow. He didn't say nothing about children. He said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow. That's what he says in the King James. Now watch what he says in the New Living Translation. Listen to what I'm saying. I want you to hear this, what God is saying. I want you to hear what he said in the New Living Translation. King James, he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow. In the New Living Translation, he says, New Living Translation, he says, I will greatly multiply thy pain. Hear that? I will greatly multiply thy pain. You see it in all your Bible real quick. Notice what it says in New Living. 3 and 16. It says, then he said to the woman, I will sharpen the pain of your pregnancy. Wow. And he says, in the pain you will give birth. And you will desire to control your husband. But he will have rule over you. So now, God said, woman, you created, you added pain to love. So now for life to come into this world, you got to go through what? Pain. So it's not the children that he said, I will greatly increase. He said the pain. So now, if it was the children he was increasing, watch this now. Very important. If it was the children that he was increasing, Deacon Rab, if God has spoken, I will give you many children. The woman would have hated the child because of the pain.
Amen.
Y'all better hear that now. It's the reason he did not say, I will give you many children. Because now you would have hated the child because of the what?
Pain.
But he promised you the pain. Not the child. Y'all better hear that now. You see that a little more? He didn't promise you the child. He said, I will increase you in pain. Not children. But what says you know love is when you know the pain and you love and you know the pain and you accept bringing life into this world for God, knowing the pain. Loving the pain before the child, loving the child during the pain, and loving the child after the pain. That's the love of God. And this is the spirit in which mothers teach us. So now we understand. You see, unless there's great pain, I can't really say whether I love somebody or not. I gave an example this morning that you really don't want to hear. She don't want to hear that example, do she? She don't want to hear this. I used to listen to Irma this morning. As a mother that showed the kind of love that very few people show. I used a late lady this morning. As a mother that showed the kind of love that only a mother can show.
Amen.
I walked out of late lady's life for 10 years. Huh? So now, who loves each other the most? I went back and got her. And she took me back. Now, which of us love each other the most? Somebody help me out. I love her more than she love me? Or she love me more than I love her?
That's right.
Because she forgave the most. She accepted the most shame to get back with this no good rascal Maurice Roberts. So now we can go to the other street. Missionary Irma and Deacon Richard. Mr. Irma, she run around here telling me, I don't love. He get on my nerve. She ain't never said she don't love. He get on my nerve, blah, 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 blah. I don't even hear. Because she took him back. And there's a love that even she didn't understand to take him back. So who loved each other the most? That's why she should be so mad, because Richard can't match her love, the love she had for him. He can't match it. But we don't want to admit the truth. God told us in the Bible, he said the one that is forgiven the most is the one that will serve me the most.
Uh-huh.
All right. There you go. He had to come in. He heard that right there. He heard his wife loving him. That way he hit that dough. Bishop, say a word, son.
Just say a word, son.
What did
he say? I didn't understand.
Just say a word. This is your bishop.
Bishop,
say a word. There you go. Irma loves you more than you love
him. You all told me that this morning.
Missionary Irma said, if you can't say nothing good, she's quiet. I thank God for it. But they're showing a love that a man can't give. I probably would have took her back. Richard probably would have took her back. If she had came to get him, if she had come to get me, I probably would have took her back, because I don't have the love of a mother. Y'all better hear this. The spirit, men, we are supposed to be taught by women. A woman as your rib completes you.
Yeah.
A woman that you cannot stay with, you will never be able to stay with. If I get a heart from somebody, and that heart, my body rejects that heart, I will die.
Amen.
A whole lot of y'all are with men and women that are not, you don't have their spiritual DNA, and you're dying while you're with them trying to prove that you love them.
Amen.
Cut it, baby! As I told them this morning, when a mother is, your mother's your first coach. I don't care if you play basketball, sports, or whatever. Your mother's your first coach. Because she kept you and your siblings from fighting. She kept your daddy from beating you when he was too mad to beat you because he would have hurt you. Mama coached him like that. Am I right, child? Can anybody relate to what I'm saying?
Amen.
So mama was your first coach.
Amen.
But I'm going to tell you something. Y'all also know what a coach does? Anybody know what a coach does? If you try for the basketball team and you ain't good enough, anybody know what the coach going to do? He going to cut you. I don't want none of y'all wives going home and say, Bishop said you weren't good enough for me, I'm going to cut you and get a knife. I'm not talking about that kind of cutting. Because I can hear her right now. You ain't good enough for me. Bishop told me to cut you, and you ain't good enough for me. Bishop told me to cut. No, I'm not talking. Y'all, because you know what Bishop say now. Let me clear that up. If a coach says you're not good enough, they're going to cut you. I don't care if you, look here, I don't care if you're the seed for the baby or not the seed for the baby. We went into that this morning, didn't we? But I don't care if you're the seed for the baby or not the seed for the baby. If you're not good for the baby, the mama going to cut you. You got to understand something. If one got to be cut, she ain't going to cut the one that she endured pain for. Me and you, stupid. Wrestle with a woman about her children. You just wait for your cut day. You just waiting for your cut day. You stupid. Do not mess with the pain. That lady, do you know what that lady went through? You are about to get cut. You messing with them children, whether you're the natural dad or not the natural, it don't even matter. You gonna get cut, you mess with them babies.
Amen.
It might take a while. But you're gonna get cut. I'm talking about the spirit of a mother. Why? Because she had the spirit of knowing what real love is. If you can't love what came out of me, how the hell, I said, how the hell you love me?
Amen.
Oh, Bishop, stop. So I'm back, y'all. Amen. And I started all over. I got a clean record. I can say anything today. And I said, the whole world had a chance to start over because of the corona. He said, you better get on the right train this time.
Amen.
Not just spirit of Jesus, but the whole world has a chance to start over.
Amen.
And I'm going to tell you now. I'm going to tell you now, the spirit of a mother is the spirit of God.
All right.
If you can't love every one of God's children, guess what? He's going to cut you and send you to hell after you meet him.
Amen.
What did you do for your brother and sister? Because you know if that's your brother and sister, they came from me. The spirit of a mother is operating in the spirit of God, the living God. He said, I will send you away for a day, but it's going to feel like 1,000 years to come. But God, before I send you, you're going to meet me and know that I am God.
Yeah,
all right. The spirit of a mother. There's nothing. If you understand the pain that she endures, that's why she protects. You mess with you can mess with a dog food, but don't mess with his puppies. You hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
You can mess with a lioness, but don't mess with them cubs.
Amen.
You hear what I'm saying? What makes a mother is not her, not that she has a child. Let's stop it, because there's a lot of mothers that have no children.
Mm-hmm.
What makes a mother is she has formed a relationship that she cannot be separated from the father of all fathers.
Amen.
What makes a mother is not her bearing children. What makes a mother, she knows a real father. And some of y'all dads, mad because your wife going to church. Now she'll cut you for the children. She might ask you for God.
Amen.
Do y'all hear what I'm saying? The spirit of a mother. When the love ain't genuine, that means when the gift don't rise, a gift makes room for what? Itself. When you're not showing that you are gifted in the area of love, a mother gonna cut you. Because if you don't love these children, I know you don't love my father. The spirit of a mother. As I leave you. Everybody all right?
Amen.
Y'all liking me right now?
Amen.
It don't matter. Really don't matter. Cause you know what? We'll be preaching tomorrow.
Amen.
Whether you like me or not.
All right.
Hello, somebody.
All right.
I'm gonna be preaching tomorrow, whether you like me or not. Y'all know that, don't you?
Huh? Amen, amen.
Y'all know that I'm gonna be preaching tomorrow, whether you like me
here?
Or not. Oh no. I'm talking about you can't put me out. Go down that road too. Got a t-shirt in that too. My God. Wow. I just want y'all to know that God loves you.
Amen.
He loves you and there's nothing that you must miss. You got to understand the spirit of a mother. Spirit of a mother. I need you to understand that. I need you to understand the spirit of a mother. Praise the Lord. I need you to understand the spirit of a mother. God is real. As I leave you, I want you to hear this. I want you to hear this because I'm going to wrap this up and you should never be the same after hearing this. You should never be the same after hearing this. And God said, and the word, I'm sorry, he said, we which were born of God, we which were born, not of blood, nor of flesh, nor of the will of man. Stop honoring what does not have a heaven or hell to put you in. Do y'all hear me? Stop honoring what does not have a heaven or hell to put you in. Honor your, y'all better hear this. He didn't say, and notice, read it. He didn't say honor your father and mother. He said honor your mother and father. Go read it. Honor the one that loves you like I do. And your mother will let you know whether or not the other one is worthy of being honored.
All right.
Y'all don't like me right now.
All right.
Whole lot of daddy said, where that Negro come from? Now, right now, you ain't using the word Negro. You use a nigga. I know what you're calling me right now, some of y'all daddy. But that's all right. I'll be that. I've been in the first time I've been called that. And going to be calling again. I'm all right. Because I know who has the heaven and hell to put me in. So I speak with confidence. I speak with boldness. If you're mad enough to do something, if you're mad enough to pull out a nine right now and take me out, you ain't getting up and did me a favor because I can't commit suicide to get there.
Amen.
I ain't mad at you. But I come to tell you, you better treat that gift that God gave you in a mother, and a mother is one that has a relationship with her father, not one that has born children. You notice what he said. She's a mother because of the will of God. God called women before he called men. He gave man a chance to lead. Y'all hear this? And man turned that lead over to the woman. So when he came back, he truly went to a place. He truly went to a place. And he called Mary Magdalene. He said, Mary Magdalene, I need you to go and tell the men. Because they seem to listen to you more than they listen to God. Adam listened to Eve rather than God. He said, since you have an ear for women, I will tell you what. You go tell a man this time. That God says he's coming back. And he's walking on this earth. When Jesus got pierced in the side and the blood hit the earth, it sanctified the earth for the return of God.
Amen.
So God can live with us now. You're in the midst of a living God. You ain't got to talk about what he did with Joseph. You ain't got to talk about what he did with John. You can talk about what he's doing with you right now. Because God said, I'm the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. As I was with him, I shall be with you. But the difference is, you are not the onlyest one like they were. Ezekiel was the onlyest prophet during his time. Nathan was the onlyest prophet during his time. Hosea was the onlyest prophet during his dispensation. But now God said, I used to speak to one to save all, but now I speak to all to what?
Save one.
And we are taught love through pain by the mother. I can love on the other side of pain because my wife would be willing to have another child for me if she could. Hello, somebody. So now what she does is she gives me children daily. She births out of me when I fall down, the love of God. She births out of me when I want to jump on deeper riches, the love of God. She births out of me. So now she is birthing. She's enduring the pain of staying with this knucklehead. So some of y'all still live. Yeah. The one first lady, some of y'all will be cut right now. I'm just talking like it is.
Amen.
The spirit of a mother. Loving before the pain. Loving during the pain.
Amen.
Imagine if women love like men. Imagine, now I want to tell y'all something. And I'm through for real. Imagine if the woman was stronger than a man. As emotional as she is.
Amen.
Me and fake emotion. We ain't, we really, we don't, when we get emotional, we acting like a woman. We fake it. But a woman is emotional for real. Imagine a pure emotional vessel with the physical strength of a man. The jail can hold them all. Do y'all understand what I'm saying?
Amen.
Do you understand what I'm saying? If a woman was a stronger vessel with the emotion that she had, the jail couldn't hold them all. Because a woman acts and then she said, she really means it when she says she's sorry. Because when she's in her emotional state, she don't care. She don't know nobody and she don't know no better and she don't care whether or not she cares. But a man, only reason we act that because the woman has outsmarted us with her words.
Yep.
And we ain't got nowhere else to go but to get physical. That's it.
Amen.
Then we get emotional.
Yeah.
When we can't match their wits, that's why I start studying. I talk just as quick as they do now. And then when they outsmart me, I walk away. You hear me? So the bottom line is, you know what? I ain't worried about what the jail gonna do to me. I'm worried about what God gonna do to me. Because you gotta understand, she displays love like God. A woman displays love like God on the other side of the pain, the spirit of a mother. Be careful what you're doing. The spirit of a mother is the spirit of what God would be if he was on this earth. Of what he is, if you could see him on this earth. He would love you through your mistakes. He would love you through the pain. He would love you through whatever you do to him. That's what why I deal with husbands. That was why I deal with children. No matter what that boy is, he still is my boy. Go get that boy out of jail. I don't care. Mamas love no matter what. Don't just say they do to children like that. My wife loves me beyond my understanding, even to this day. Richard, you need to be thankful. For the spirit of her having the spirit of a mother. Man, I hope somebody got some out of this today.
Amen.
Did you get some out of this today?
Yes.
The spirit of a mother is like God. There was no pain. Can you imagine the pain that God had? Imagine, KK, what's your dog's name?
Yen.
Imagine Yen loving me more than he loved you and tell you he don't want to go home with you no more. Huh? That would really hurt. Imagine you walking in the house. Your wife just left you, and you walk in the house, and your boys walk up to the other man and say, "Hey, Daddy, what we going to eat today? Daddy, what you going to give me today?" And then they walk back and say, "Hey, Richard, what's going on?" Imagine
what I told you. What I told you.
You see what I'm saying? Imagine. You understand what I'm saying? Your daughter walking up to you and calling the other woman mama and calling you D. Imagine. Wouldn't that hurt a little bit? You be able to try to choke the other woman. What you done did to my baby? No, it's what you didn't do.
Yeah,
huh? If that man called the other man a daddy and called you Richard, it's something you didn't
do.
The one you need to be jumping on is not somebody else. It's something you didn't do. If my wife cheated on me, I know this girl loved me with all her heart when she met me. If she cheated on me, I ain't gonna jump on him or her. I really said, what did I do to lose that kind of love? And what can I do to get it back? I'm going to go check in with God. I ain't going to beat nobody up and go to jail. I'm going to check in with God. What did I do to lose that kind of love? It's something I did. The spirit of a mother should teach you that. A woman will lead. A mother sticks to it no matter what. A mother endures no matter what. Not just for children, but for strangers. Not just for children, but for husbands. Not just for children, but for their enemies. Some people have seen people enemize bishops. I can name them, but I don't want to get into that because God is going to bring them all back. This whole church can be full of old members.
Amen.
They were never my enemies. The door was always open.
Amen.
But I had to learn from my wife how to love what hates me. Because there was a time I didn't realize I was treating her with hate when I thought I was treating her with what?
Love.
But she stayed. She endured. She still kept cooking for me, but it shouldn't matter enough I didn't eat that plate.
Amen.
You better take a temperature. Y'all know they got this thing now where you just walk around and it'll tell you what somebody took. You better get that with your wife. You better get one of them temperature checkers for your wife. I'm through, y'all. But I pray y'all penetrated somebody today. I pray that you will reach down. I'm not with the hooping and hollering and getting you excited. It's not about that. It's about you having something to lean on come Thursday and Friday to get you back the next Sunday. Hello, somebody. Amen. You come in here, I can grab you. I can choke you with the words. I can say, well, I grab my ear, but guess what? By the time you walk out that door, you'll be cussing out somebody because they ask you, I call a deacon this week. It might have been you. I called a deacon. I couldn't have been you because you ain't got no wife yet. It couldn't have been you because you ain't got no wife. I called one of my deacons who got a wife this week. I didn't call him. I really didn't. He called me. His wife had his phone all day long. First of all, why you thumbing through the phone trying to find out who your wife been talking to? I want to know what's going on. You see, when I used to check on my wife, it wasn't what my wife was doing, it was what I was doing. And he called me, he said, who is this? You called this phone? I changed my voice. I said, yeah, I called this phone. I said, but I wasn't looking for you. I was looking for her. That deacon used some words that I didn't know he had in his mouth. That deacon used a word. They told me you can take a brother out of Pompano, but you can't take the Pompano out of the brother.
Trying to tell
you. We don't use them kind of, I ain't never heard of that word.
Get him, Lick.
But you know what? Did I get mad at the deacon? No, why not? Because I know he's still growing in God.
Amen.
I know he's still growing in God. Amen?
Amen.
The spirit of a mother. Love beyond the pain. Love knowing the pain gonna come. Don't stop loving. At the end of the day, the spirit of a mother, a real mother has the spirit of God. Her love is everlasting. Her love never ends. See, y'all, ladies won't sit there thinking about it. I must be got the spirit of a mother. The way she thinking about cheer right now. I must be got the spirit of a mother. I saw it all in you. Yeah, do I have a gift, Lady Mo? Lady Mo, tell me, do I have a gift, Lady Mo?
I please.
Let's go home, y'all. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. We thank you. We thank you for all things. We thank you for this word that we can enjoy you, Lord. We can receive you, and we can feel ourselves. One thing about, I want to be convicted when I come to church. Because if I don't, if I'm not convicted by the word, I will end up being a convict of the jailhouse.
Amen.
Convict me now, Lord, so I won't be a convict there. I thank you right now, Lord, for everybody in this sanctuary. And God said, if there's anybody that needs prayer, come to the altar right now. If there's anybody that wants prayer, come to the altar right now. We're going to do this quickly. We're going to pray in unity. If there's anybody that needs prayer, come to the altar right now. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus just now. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. God bless you, my brother. Thank you for coming. Just now. What will he do? He will save you. He will save you. He will save you. Just now.
Just now.
He will save you. He will save you. He will save you. Just now. He will save you. He will save you. He will save you just now. He will save you. He will save you just now.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I did that wrong.
Everybody turn to somebody. Everybody turn to somebody. I need two people look. Everybody looking at somebody. Okay. Hey, Jay, come look at your grandma.
Brain change with you.
I take the phone.
Yeah. So everybody look at somebody. You can wrap, you turn that way. No, you don't have to do nothing. You go over there, you come over here. Okay. Y'all look confident in each other. Come over there. Everybody look at somebody. All right. You go look at her. Everybody look at somebody. Come on. Okay. I'm looking at Mr. Irma. And repeat after me. Hey, you.
Hey, you.
Get off your high mountain.
Get off your high mountain.
Be concerned about me.
Be concerned about me.
Know that I'm ashamed of my life. Hear me screaming for help. But my pride won't let me say help. So come off your mountain. And concern yourself with somebody else. Knowing that God loves you already. Say, hey you. Will you do that for me? And if you will, you got the sermon today. Because you will be exemplifying. The spirit of a mother.
God
bless you.